was young, the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Miromir and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argoth, Rhond, and Gondolin. He was on carven throne in many pillared walls of stone with golden roof and silver floor and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and cooling shining lamps of crystal gold, and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
their chisel clove and graver wrote,
their forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason.
Their peril pearl and opal pale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and corse, light axe and sword and shining spears were laid in war.
Unwearied then were two folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forges fire. Darkness dwells in Durin's halls. The shadow lies upon his tomb, in Moria, in Khazad-dûm.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless
is crowning water deep.